Like many Muay Thai legends before him, one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, started Muay Thai when he was a child. Despite growing up in extreme poverty, Rodtang rose above his challenges to reach the pinnacle of striking. You're watching One Championship's Warrior Spirit. Known for his exciting come-forward style, Rodtang Jitmuangnon entered ONE Super Series to much fanfare in September 2018. Although Dutch powerhouse Sergio Weltzit engaged him in a thrilling three-round battle, Rodtang's power and accuracy overwhelmed the Dutchman. And the judges awarded the unanimous decision victory to Rodtang. Following that sensational debut performance, the Thai superstar backed up his big reputation with another three-round thriller. Pushed to the limit against Tunisian striker Fadi Khalid, Rodtang lived up to his nickname, the Iron Man. We move ahead to the third round.
I'd like to see more of that same round from Fadi Khalid. What he did in the second, he needs to do more of it here in the third. Start moving, do not stand in front of Rodtang.
Rodtang with the inside leg kick, almost bucking the knee of Fadi Khalid. Khalid with the right hand, hand cross, so to the hook of Rodtang. On the front foot again, the 21-year-old two-time world champion.
See, this time, look, this time he's circling to his right, away from the power side of Rodtang. So Rodtang's having to overextend on the right side. He's not able to put the same power into his shots.
Nice lead elbow there from Fadi Khalid.
He's got to keep in mind the rule set. You can't clinch, you can clinch, but you can't take down off the clinch. And that's what Fadi Khalid was doing. It's buying him a little bit of time, and it's slowing down the tank. But you know, you can't do that. He's issued a yellow card. It's going to cost him 10% of his purse. Doesn't cost him a point, though, just money.
Front kick there from Rodtang. Jab from Fadi Khalid. It's preservation in the clinch for Khalid, I'm sure of it. Front kick to a nice slow jab at a southpaw stance. Khalid maybe come lifting in the eye. Rodtang says, come on, let's do this. There's the handiwork from Rodtang. Here's the heavy artillery. The clinch now. The beautiful clinch from Rodtang. The vice like grip of the tie. Beautiful knee almost folded in half.
Rodtang's competing like he's got a couple more rounds in here. I don't know if he realizes that he's only got 90 seconds left in this match. He's got to turn up the volume right now and put an end to this.
A crowd turning up the volume for Rodtang Jitmuangnon, a crowd favorite wherever he competes around the world. Spinning back elbow there from Fadi Khalid. Big kick from Rodtang. Khalid trying to find a way to break the overhand right. Nice kick for the liver from Rodtang. Flows down that vagus nerve, impact the entire body. Put it on delay. Leads under the hook for Khalid, sticks him with the left there, the right hand from Khalid. Good two-punch combination. Go! Dump there from Rodtang, Rodtang. Under a minute remaining, Dragon.
Rodtang is letting Khalid off the hook. He kind of throws a bunch of combinations. He throws those three, four punch combinations, and then he goes in for the clinch rather than finish him on the feet. He's got good advantage and he's moving. But he can't lift it himself.
Looking into the crowd to see that left hook that missed. It was thrown that hard back. Rodtang, full commitment behind it. Oh, there's a sticky right hand between the eyes of Rodtang. Downstairs comes Rodtang with the leg kick. Spinning back fist from Khalid. Rodtang hasn't taken a backward step for three rounds. Downward elbow. And dumps him again.
Go!
Final seconds. Has one man got a big salvo left here? Khalid tries for it. Two-time world champion Rodtang comes forward once more. One sweep there by Fadi Khalid. And we go to the judges here in Manila. What sportsmanship, what respect there from Rodtang and Fadi Khalid. The martial arts code, the Bushido spirit.
All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. from the blue corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Absolutely no doubt about it. And again, the sportsmanship that sets one championship and one Super Series athletes apart from all the rest. Rodtang Jitmuangnon, 2-0 now in one Super Series.
Born into a family of 12 in a small village in southern Thailand, Rodtang Jitmuangnon grew up in extreme poverty. But that inspired him to dedicate his life to Muay Thai so he could provide for his family.
Rodtang says, come on! What have you got? Show me your guts and intestinal fortitude!
เขามาจากครอบครัวที่ยากจนนะคะเนื่องจากว่าพี่น้องเขาเยอะมากพี่น้องเขาทั้งหมดมีประมาณ10คนได้แล้วก็พ่อแม่เขาแยกทางกันนะคะเหมือนว่าแยกกันอยู่ทุกคนต้องหากินด้วยลําแข้งของตัวเอง
แล้วก็ทุกอย่างอย่างเพราะฐานะก็ไม่ดีใช่ครับก็จะพาไปตามงานศพก็ไปล้างจานอะไรพวกนี้ก็ทําหมดเก็บเศษเหล็กบ้างอะไรเงี้ยครับมาขายเพื่อเลี้ยงดูลูกๆทุกคนพ่อก็ทำงานรู้สึกเสียใจนะบางครั้งก็แบบอย่างเราตอนเด็กเนี้ยไปโรงเรียนเพื่อนๆเขามีของเล่นบ้างอยากกินในนู่นก็ได้กินเราก็ไปโรงเรียนได้วันละ10บาทตอนประถม10บาทอย่างเงี้ย5บาทบางวันก็ตอนเด็กๆอ่ะรู้สึกกับเรายังไงไม่นะครับเพราะลูกเยอะแกก็ไม่ค่อยได้มาดูแลทุกคนถึงเพราะผมอ่ะพี่สาวจะเป็นคนดูแลใช่แบบเขาก็ต้องทำมาหากินนึกว่าเอ้ยมวยเนี่ยแล้วเขาได้ถามเขาว่าชกมันก็ได้ค่าตัวชก3ยกบางครั้งก็5ยกก็ได้ค่าตัวก็อยากชอบครับชอบซ้อมไปเรื่อยแบบชอบเลยแบบก็แต่ช่วงแรกคือทางค่ายก็ไม่ค่อยสนใจเพราะเราไม่เป็นอะไรเลยแต่เราก็อาศัยแบบลูกตื้อลูกมือเนี่ยครับไปค่ายทุกวันไปกวาดกระยะบนเวทีบ้างไปทำให้เขาเห็นแววเราใช่ก็ประมาณใช้เวลาวันปีนี่กว่าที่เขาจะแบบมึงอยากชกเหรอครับมึงอยากชกก็ representing
Thailand ถังประเภทต่อยมวยใช่ไหมต่อยมวยประเภทคนสนุกไม่ออกแบบคนดูเอนเตอร์เทนคนดูเก่งคือชกยังไงคือคุ้มบาทคุ้มเงินทุกบาททุกสตางค์คนที่เสียเข้าค่าบัตรไปดูไม่มีถอยไม่มียอมให้กับผู้ต่อสู้ถึงแม้เขาจะเป็นผู้เพียงความแต่คือคนได้ใจคนดูอะครับเป็นมวยชกสนุกมากเอนเตอร์เทนทั้งเอนเตอร์เทนทั้งดูดันด้วยผสมประสานกันในตัวของรุ่นถัง
ตอนนั้นอายุ14ปีครับขึ้นมาวันแรกก็ร้องไห้ครับคือไม่เคยเห็นสีแสงเสียงในกรุงเทพตกใจนั่งรถก็ร้องไห้ขึ้นมาวันแรกก็แบบพยายามโทรหาพี่สาวว่าอยู่ไหนเสียงเสียงเสียงอะไรคิดถึงบ้านอยากกลับตอนแรกก็แบบกันนพรก็เข้ามาบอกมาพอบว่าต้องอยู่ได้นะเรามาสร้างอนาคตเขาก็สอนเขาก็เหมือนพ่อคนที่สองครับก็แบบก็แรกก็เราออกมาจากบ้านนะเราคิดที่จะเดินในสายนี้แล้วใช่เรารักในสิ่งนี้แล้วเราก็ต้องเติบโตด้วยตัวเองละถ้าเราจะไปพึ่งแบบเกาะติดพ่อแม่นี้มันไม่ได้ละเพราะพี่น้องก็เยอะแล้วก็ฐานะทางบ้านก็ไม่ดีเราก็ต้องเนี่ยอย่างเช่นเรามีเหมือนงานของเราเนี่ยเราได้เงินเราเลี้ยงดูชีวิตของเราแล้วก็ครอบครัวได้แบ่งเบาภาระเนี่ยมันก็ต้องตั้งใจละครับผม
Rodtang left home in his mid-teens to join the famed Jitmuangnon gym in Bangkok. At first, the teenager found the move to the big city intimidating. But under the care and mentorship of Mr. Wan, the gym's owner and head coach, Rodtang found the stability he needed to unleash his true potential. So when his mentor passed away suddenly, Rodtang suffered a great loss.
เขาบอกว่าพ่อเสียแล้วก็ผมแบบทำอะไรไม่ถูกคือแบบความรู้สึกผมกับพ่ออ้วนครับก็แบบพ่อลูกกันครับแบบคืออยู่ด้วยกันพ่อจะเขา เป็นทุกอย่างครับเหมือนพ่อแท้ๆแบบคอยสอน
คนคิดว่าเด็กเนี่ยเสียพ่อไปแล้วไม่มีกำลังใจชกมวยแน่เขาเนี่ยเป็นคนกระตุ้นทุกอย่างกระตุ้นเด็กแบบต้องสู้เพื่อแม่นะเพื่อให้แม่เรียกชื่อจิตเบิงนนท์กลับขึ้นมาทุกครั้งที่ขึ้นเวทีช่วงที่พี่อ้วนเสียชีวิตนะเด็กนักมวยชนะรวดเลยคือเกินคาดอ่ะ
ที่คนที่หวังเนี่ยทางค่ายหรือว่าเอาแชมป์มาค่ายได้เนี่ยก็เป็นมันสำคัญที่สุดอ่ะในวันที่2เนี่ยคือจริงแชมป์เนี่ยมันสำคัญกับผมมาก
To honor the late coach Hwan, Rodtang was determined to prove himself as the greatest flyweight Muay Thai athlete on the planet. In 2019, he challenged Jonathan Haggerty for the one flyweight Muay Thai world title. We join the world championship bout in round three.
Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Gyeonghadeo. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Gyeonghadeo never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
And you see what's up now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater. And he'll start the heavy silverbacks. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks like he's returned the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs, and referee O'Nari breaks it.
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot. Not allow Haggerty to go forward and control all those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Roger that man slipping down. He looks to his leg of the edge as Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes, drifts back clockwise, thrusts out the jab. See Rodtang trying to walk him down. He wasn't doing that the first two rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand and go toe to toe? Is he going to play that game? Is he going to try to let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Rodtang goes to the liver. Haggerty felt that one. Double forearms guard is high. He's forearms guard there. Haggerty tags him. And now he'll take time. They're checking it out in the phone booth. Smack bang goes Haggerty. And Rodtang thrusts out the lead leg. Goes to the waist. Haggerty counters body shot. High kick. Haggerty thrusts out the trap. Circles off to his left. But he's going into the power side. Another liver shot. Like he's digging for oil. This is a great round for Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick. Takes the inside thigh kick. Goes high. Misses the target. Checks the low kick. Jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though.
Better round for Rodtang. This is what we'd expect from the Iron Man to go forward and throw
a
knee.
He's
landing a lot clear shots. We're seeing the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and aah, but Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab two combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catch and dump there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang. A fantastic round from both men. But did Rodtang edge that one?
Do you like the counters of Haggerty so far? I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again from Haggerty, finding range. Outside leg kick from Rodtang.
Pressure.
The hooking punches and the power of the forearms blocks. You see Haggerty trying to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick. Nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice take to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick. Threads the jab again. Takes an outside leg kick. Body shots. Oh, oh, the shots hurt him. The little shots hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. Rodtang marching him down, eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, stop dancing, come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow, hoping for the collarbone. Jab, but he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, he's going to the right, stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. He says, this is for a belt, come on, let's go toe to toe.
And how about this?
Get into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no, you come on, you bring it. I'm not coming to you. You've got to come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games, though. He's still moving, though. He's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says, let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games. Saying, I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's going to come down to the fifth and final. With that knockdown, Rodtang could have a slight edge in the scoring. If the scorecards, depends on how the judges saw that third round. It's very close right now. Look at him coming forward. Boom! With just a wild hooking combination sends the champion crumbling to the mat as Rodtang starts to turn on the heat. Look at that right hand comes through the guard.
This is one for the ages. Haggerty engaging in the mind games with Rodtang. And there's a moment of respect. The fifth and final round. Title. They touch gloves. It could be drawn at the moment. Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. It changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty cheek down the center, needs the elbows, 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And the general goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of an opponent is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Tries to push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with these legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah,
look at that.
Haggerty's round so far, no doubt about it.
That's scoring, Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws 2 punches, doesn't connect, tucks the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hooks to the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. There's a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1:05 remaining, fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab 2 from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty. It has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologising.
Okay.
I think saying no, maybe having accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. And he thread an overhand elbow to the top of the head, perhaps. Or maybe skip in for a jab over to the collarbone.
30 seconds, Michael. This is it, right here. Last 30.
There's one of these two men pounce on the other now. Jab to a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice two landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
Haggerty can take this round. It might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws. We are going down to the judges. This is razor close. This is harder to pick than a broken nose. I don't know what to say about this one, Mitch.
If it's harder to pick than a broken nose. If it goes to the judges, that's just scorecards. Your nose thing threw me off. And then right now it could be even. If Haggerty won that round, right now it could be even as a draw. Then it goes to the judges' scorecards. Then you have to factor in who did the most damage. And does the knockdown score the highest? It could go to, oh man, so many variables.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision, and new one Flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang
champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon, the Czech, the Iron Man.
That same year, in October, ONE Championship celebrated its 100th show in Tokyo. And in the biggest martial arts event in history, Rodtang Jitmuangnon made his first world title defense against Brazilian phenom, Walter Goncalves. In the first round, both Rodtang and Goncalves moved forward with their most powerful combinations. The action continued the same way in the next two rounds, with Rodtang pushing the pace and Goncalves countering off his back foot. Let's go to the action in the final round.
Fifth and final round, still anyone for the taking, okay, for the ONE Super Series Flyweight Muay Thai World Championship. There's the champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon. And what a moment of honor to kick off this championship round. The southpaw Walter Goncalves of Brazil, giving Rodtang a contest unlike anything we've seen before here in ONE Super Series. Clinching these early.
You can see he's looking for that again. Nice little trip there. Good balance shown by Goncalves.
Stop.
Now, what Rodtang was complaining about is you're not allowed to pick somebody up and then throw them. That's what he was questioning the referee about.
Rodtang edging forward. Fake there from Goncalves, two punch combination, gets out of the range of the counter, right hand. Knees from Rodtang. That one to the lower spine, not permitted, referee Jalapsis breaks them. Rodtang comes forward again. He wants a brawl with Goncalves. Goncalves refuses to be suckered in. AKA Brazilian kick.
Up,
which is
the end
of a Brazilian.
But
great Brazilian kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years, the likes of Flaubei Feitosa, of course, one's own Cosmo Alessandre, Francisco Filio.
But
Rodtang backing up Goncalves, scooping bolo punch into the midsection. High kick there from Rodtang. It's time for Goncalves to start landing some scoring shots now.
He's backing up still. He's got good head movement. He's able to get all the power shots, but he's not getting suckered in by the psychological games of Rodtang.
Overhand elbow from Goncalves. Double forearms guard against the round kick. Rodtang continually on the front foot.
Stop! Well, it's all right.
Rodzak was complaining about the throw off a dump earlier, but how about that from Rodzak? Tying him up with almost a choke there. Left hook from Rodzak. Roundhouse kick. Good counter right hand from Gonsalves. Southpaw stance has gone to orthodox now, Gonsalves, and it's working for him.
And that right hand slips right through the guard. It's scoring heavily. Gonsalves.
Spinning back elbow. That's Rodzak. Got underneath it. Switching stance, Gonsalves just trying to confound Rodzak a little more. 30 seconds remaining. Final round. He's going to engage.
He's trying to push forward, but Gonsalves just slides out of the way, ends up on the other side of the circle, evading all counter shots.
A very frustrating contest for Rodtang Jitmuangnon. Walter Gonsalves' introduction to ONE Super Series will win him a lot of fans. And there it is. We're going down the judges here in Tokyo.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of the blue corner. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of the red corner. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision.
ONE Flyweight Muay Thai World Champion Rodtang Jitmuangnon had a rewarding 2019. The Thai superstar firmly established himself as the best flyweight Muay Thai athlete in the world. And as the new year rolled in, 2020 presented a fresh set of challenges for Rodtang. The former world title holder, Jonathan Haggerty, was back to reclaim the gold he lost. But in front of his home country in Thailand, Rodtang is never going to let go of his belt.
เป็น ตีนเขิด ใช่ เป็น ต้นตำรับ ของ Muay Thai และ เป็น ผม ที่ ป้องกัน แชมป์ ก็ ใน วัน ผม ก็ จะ ทำ หน้า ที่ ให้ ดี ที่ สุด ครับ จะ รักษา แชมป์ ไว้ ให้ นาน ที่ สุด ครับ ก็ รู้สึก มั้ย ครับ ก็ รู้สึก ครับ แบบ ว่า มัน ก็ ใน บ้าน เรา กำลัง ใจ ก็ ดี แล้ว ก็ อีก อย่าง ผม ก็ จะ เอา พ่อ แม่ ครอบ ครัว ผม มา ดู ทุก คนที่ไม่เคยให้พ่อแม่มาดูคือไฟนั้นจะผมจะให้พ่อแม่เอารถมาก็มาดูผมในวันนั้นครับผมเป็นคนที่ไม่อยากให้พ่อแม่มาดูต่อยเพราะแบบพ่อแม่เห็นลูกต่อยแล้วทุกคนก็จะแบบลูกเจ็บใช่ครับก็เลยต้องร้องไห้ผมก็ต้องมาปลอบใจพ่อแม่แทนที่จะดูแลผมนะผมก็เลยตัดสินใจคือพ่อแม่ไม่ต้องมาดูผมดีกว่าตั้งแต่เด็กเลยครับจนถึงทุกวันนี้ครับคือเนื่องจากตอนนี้พ่อผมป่วยด้วยครับไม่สบายครับผมพ่อผมเลยได้ถามพ่อว่าพ่ออยากดูผมชกไหมเขาก็เลยบอกอยากดูมากหมอบอกว่าเป็นโรคร้ายครับเนื้อร้ายครับเนื้อร้ายครับก็ไฟนี้วันที่10มกราผมก็จะสู้เพื่อพ่อของผมครับ
Tonight. He said he would. He said he'd go in early against Haggerty. Haggerty told us, I'm playing to Rodtang's ego. Says Rodtang has a massive ego. Rodtang will want to play to the crowd, and that will open him up. Rodtang looks to the inside and outside front. Haggerty left roundhouse kick. Rodtang goes for the liver. A taste of the power rolling. It makes 4 rounds close. There is no room for error. Good right hand there from Haggerty. There's a front kick in the face, and Haggerty's home! The body shot! The body shot tied up the first round! And the aggressive stance from Rodtang!
Seven!
The body shot hurts Haggerty!
Let's go! steps out of the carpet. There he goes again. Haggerty against the ropes. He's in trouble. And Rodtang, cool and collected, throws the elbow to the orbital.
Haggerty's got to move. He cannot stand in front of Rodtang like this. He's got to get on that bicycle and start circling now. If his body is damaged, he's got to move. Utilize that push kick, keep that distance. Do not stand in punching range with Iron Man.
Outside leg kick from Rodtang. He's hurt the body of Haggerty. The little shot dropping the man from the UK. Back to left now. Looks for a duck as Haggerty. Can't affect it. Throws the knee to the waist of Rodtang.
Stop!
And referee directs to
Rodtang.
One star goes from Rodtang, the champion. Good jab there from Haggerty. Rodtang goes back to the liver. He may be telegraphing it. Goes upstairs with a hook of the lead hand. Good right hand down the center corridor. Outside front again. Another digging liver shot like he's digging for oil. It's all about the liver. It's all about the body work from Rodtang here in the first round. And he goes top of the thigh. Throws an overhand elbow. Puts the jab in the face again. Circles on clockwise. Checks the low kick. He's moving into Rodtang's power side. High kick again. Feet meet mouth. Final 10 seconds of a 10-8 round here from Rodtang. Throws the left hand. Overhand elbow from Haggerty trying to lock the ear up. Van Gogh style. Body shot from Rodtang. End of the first round, we go to the towels. Folks, don't forget to follow us on Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, at ONE Championship.
Rodtang goes to the body. Look at that. Hurt him again. You saw it in the first exchange where he went down low with the hook to the body, and then he's kept going after it, finding a home for that left hand right in the liver. Just shut down Haggerty to score an 8 count. Right at the beginning of the round.
It was a perfectly placed liver shot from Rodtang.
Stand back.
Impacting that vagus nerve. It closes down the whole body. Second round set for 5. 10-8 opening round for Rodtang. Front kick there from Haggerty.
Yes!
Very light on the lead foot. Switches to southpaw here because the man from the UK. Rodtang edging his way forward, trying to get inside the phone booth. A land that with a shot again. Haggerty back to here. Orthodox stance. Rodtang goes to the liver. What do you do though when Rodtang is hunting your liver? You drop your arm down, you do that when he goes after your head. Switching stances here, Haggerty.
He's got to stay mobile. He has to keep that push kick coming, utilize those kicks. Keep him at distance. Do not let him get close like this.
When Rodtang gets close, Haggerty's got to throw the elbow. He's got to hope to open up Rodtang. That was part of the game plan. Let Rodtang come to him.
Stop.
Slice and dice and play with the elbow. Rodtang continually coming forward. So calm, so composed. Chin tuck, looking through his brow. Goes the liver again. He knows that's the sweet spot. It's like a target painted on the right side of the body of Jonathan Haggerty. Up down there. Serves referee Deluxe, so touch gloves. Halfway through the second round of 5, this world title match. Haggerty with the kick to kick. Jab from Jonathan Haggerty, the former world champion. Won the title by defeating the great Sanmai Ganga Dao in Jakarta. Lost the title to Rodtang in Manila.
Beautiful evasion there, the sweep for Rodtang as he got airborne, as Haggerty tried to sweep out that support leg.
Switching stance again, Haggerty from southpaw to orthodox. Orthodox is his preferred stance. Body shot from Rodtang. Haggerty against the ropes, gets off there, drifts back to center rim. Looks for the inside leg. Want to see the overhand elbows coming to play here from Haggerty. Only a spin back elbow off the air. Rodtang, he goes for a little shot of his own. There's a front kick to the guts.
Haggerty's got to be careful when Rodtang catches those kicks. You can see how Rodtang's throwing the legs aside, and then he starts digging for those body shots.
Coming in with the elbows again on that occasion, though I feel the left side of the head of Rodtang was exposed. Southpaw stands, back leg kick, gets a forward, goes to the liver again. I've lost count of how many body shots to the liver Rodtang has thrown inside of 2 rounds.
And Michael, if Rodtang tries to go in for those elbows, he's going to close that distance and enter Rodtang's punching range. I think he wants to keep that distance, keep that space. That's why he's not coming into those elbows. And Rodtang pumps his fist in the air.
A better round there for Jonathan Agony. Don't forget, folks, you scored on a 10-point must system. Give the winner of the round 10 points. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Look at this. Is that amazing? Last time at this stage, it was Haggerty who was owning the contest. He easily won the first 2 rounds. The first time, not so tonight. He is staring down a 10-8 opening round where he got knocked down. And possibly a 10-9 second round for Rodtang. The jab goes to the Haggerty. Rodtang forcing him back against the rocks. Haggerty doesn't want to go there. Dark for Rodtang, nicely executed. Needs to get to that take kick. Needs those elbows. Booking punches from Rodtang. Agony calls him forward. That's usually what Rodtang does to opponents. Is he going to try and open up the ego now of Rodtang? We haven't seen Rodtang slap his face or pound his chest or play to the audience yet. It's been a much more tame Rodtang. It's been a very aggressive Rodtang.
Right. This is where Haggerty's got to be careful. He can't engage in these types of exchanges with Rodtang, where he gets put pushing backwards, because that's how he lost his foot and got knocked down in the fourth round last time. He has to keep his footwork going, utilize those shots. There's that downward elbow that you were calling for, Michael.
Going for the collarbone tracker. There's a little shot from Rodtang. Haggerty having words with Elias Delopsis. The referee.
Injury time.
Something in the eye of Haggerty. It's an injury time being called here as the doctor takes a look at the eye of Jonathan Haggerty. Haggerty, I feel, is trying to enter into the mental space of Rodtang here in the third. He wants Rodtang's ego to open up so Rodtang will maybe expose himself, maybe leave himself open and make a mistake. There it is, a thumb in the eye off the left hand, accidentally, of course, from Rodtang. It's Muay Thai in 4 rounds gloves. It's the main event of ONE Championship, and you tomorrow, the first show of 2020. A massive 50 events across all of ONE Championship's platforms for 2020. Our biggest year is upon us. Jonathan Haggerty needs to find a way to turn the tide here. But knocked out in the opening round, courtesy of a little shot. Rodtang up in his face in the second round. Rodtang wanting Haggerty to come forward on him. Haggerty refusing. He wants Rodtang to come forward on him. He wants to bait Rodtang. Hope that Rodtang will make a mistake. He'll slip up. He'll leave himself exposed. Haggerty on the outside. Rodtang about to up the aggressive meter, it looks like. Good right hand there. Jaw rattler from Haggerty. Another one there from the bridge. Rodtang backs him off. Body shot coming back. playing the round all over. Have a look at the onslaught. 4 ounce gloves. One of the hardest hitters in the combat world going to your body like that. Glancing left. Powerful right to the orbital. You see the eyes of Haggerty. A little bit glassed there as he backs off. But Rodtang just kept coming forward. There was no relent. Left hook. Right hand, Haggerty. Double forearms guard, has a look, lifts the arms. As he lifts the arms, Rodtang goes the body. And then he goes straight to the center. The solar plexus, followed by the liver shot, followed by the head shot. Boom to the liver, clean liver shot. Digs the knuckles in, impacts that vagus nerve, closes down the body, ends the match, retains the world title.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Elias Dolepsis, has called a stop to this contest after 2 minutes and 39 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of technical knockout! And still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang!
Planet. He entered the Matrix when he jumped that sweep, and then he went absolutely bananas. A rampaging beast of a martial artist to get the three knockdown finish on Jonathan Haggerty in the third round. The rain of gold around the Impact Arena in Bangkok.
This is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.